Cursor's software engineering interview process. Here's what engineers are saying about this process. This is the most interesting interview process I've done. I felt like I was an engineer at the company. There might not be a better company in the world at interviews when it comes to a few things. Number one, practical engineering interviews and open use of AI. You'd think companies like Anthropic or OpenAI and all of the rest of them would be having LLM use open and happening during their technical rounds, but it's actually a lot more rare than you'd think. Whereas you have Cursor, which has wide open usage, which we'll get to later. Also, it requires a different kind of prep, which we do have a pretty good strategy that we feel good about. Overall, Cursor is full of energetic and spontaneous people. It's people that want to get stuff shipped out quickly. They're getting an update out like every day or two. Working hours can be intense though, so it's something to be aware of. Obviously, pay is going to be tier one. They've got a 200-person team. They're very flat, and that's kind of the theme with these you know, hot AI companies. Basically, they want everyone to be able to talk to anyone and to be able to build whatever they want. Getting into the interview process step by step by step. Normal process looks like this. Tech screen, hiring manager, in either order. Really cool on-site, which could take a place over a day or 2 days. And they're going to ask you to build like 1 to 3 projects in a very cool way, which we'll talk about. And they do their culture fit screens during the meal breaks, which is another very cool kind of first principles way to design an interview and very impressive. Let's start with just a hiring manager screen. So the hiring manager at Cursor, some of them don't have recruiters. This is important because that means that they are doing their own recruiting, which means that you can do your own reverse recruiting, which means hitting up hiring managers at Cursor if you have relevant skills. This is going to be informal, as with all the interviews. These are cool interviewers, man. They're informal, they're casual. They're going to ask you, you know, why Cursor? They're going to ask you resume-based questions, try to see if it's a fit, right? Then the technical coding interview. This is where things start to get interesting. So here's what it looks like. They give you a repo, a piece of their real repo. They give you 60 minutes. And they say, hey, this is an algorithm we're currently using in our code, and we wanted to see you implement it, right? Super practical. So it's not really leak codey. The solution might be leak codey, you could argue, just because it's DSA, but the way that you input the parameters, input your data, all that stuff is real world. And now the really cool thing here is they have the open use of Cursor, GPT, and Google in this tech screen. And they tell you the whole time that we want you to search with syntax using these tools. It's not completely open where you can use those tools any way you want, but they do that at the final round interview, the onsite. So that'll come later. Let's go to the final round interview. So this is going to be like an 8-hour block. It's going to simulate a real work day. You can make it 4 hours on one day, 4 hours another, 8 hours on one day. But they're going to have you in the office. They're going to give you a project, 1 to 3 projects. Again, real piece of code, very limited documentation. And they're going to give you a prompt that is intentionally vague to see how you would develop new features. So let's go through this a little bit. So the code they give you, this might change depending on, but if they, depending on your level, if they just ask you to do one project at the final round, there's maybe 2 to 3 services in the repo that they give you, something like, you know, spanning their backend, connecting to their APIs or something. If they give you up to 3 projects, which is if you're more senior, they can do that at the final round on site, in which case it's probably going to be 6 to 9 services or 4 to 6 services. We're not exactly sure how many, but it should be roughly in that area. But the whole idea here is to just throw you into the deep end with not a lot of documentation and not a lot of a prompt, and just say, see stuff that you would like to build and then build it. And then we have a Slack channel where you can Slack anyone you need to ask questions. So what they're really trying to do is measure your ability to make engineering trade-offs, your ability to be productive without a lot of foresight or without a lot of resources. Also, completely open use in this final round of Google and Cursor and ChatGPT. So they want you to work exactly like you are going to work when you are there, which is shipping fast, having little documentation, specking up features just because you know that you should build them, your own product manager in a sense. So really amazing interview process. I challenge any other company out there to have a better interview process in terms of open use of LLM tools, practical process, and they're not skimping on culture here. They're going to have you over during that final round on site for meals, and you're going to do vibe checks with the team, and you're going to see if you like them and see if they like you. So overall, The way to prep for this is a little bit different. What you got to get really good at, and it is weird, lead code's not going to help you here. It's just not. What's going to help you is get into an unfamiliar code base, extra points if it has a similar tech stack to Cursor. They use Rust and they use TypeScript. Also extra points if it has features that are similar to something that Cursor has built. And then in a very short amount of time, hack up a new feature. You can use a time constraint of a couple hours. You can get it down to, 2 hours for a feature. That would be amazing. Even less would be amazing. But just start by going into unfamiliar code bases and hacking out a feature quickly and slowly constrain your time more and more, and you will be aces for this interview process. If you like practical interviews, if you like companies where it feels like working there during the interview, go check out Cursor. Thanks, and in your interviews, break a leg.